Night City driving in a cyberpunk universe song. Off rip. Till I just burn down the booth. Human torch can't fuck with me. Johnny Blaze, suspect B, striking quick, lightning fast, melt them bitches down to ash. Gasoline. Well, damn, hold up. What's good, y'all? It is I, Reggie Wolf, and today is the day that many of y'all have been waiting on. I am checking out the official soundtrack for Ruby Volume 1. And yeah, I know it's been a minute. I know I checked out, you know, the first episode of Volume 2, but I'm in the right headspace today. Now, one thing that I'm going to this knowing is because y'all let me know this in the comments, is that the singer apparently for most of the songs, if not all the songs, it was like 13, 14, or 15 years old. Like, they were really young when they did this. So I just want to give them their flowers on that, because at 14, 15, you know, I was not on that kind of wave at all. So with that being said, if y'all enjoy any of the songs you hear in this and you have not watched Ruby, go head over to the Rooster Teeth website and hit them with the goodness. That's like, comment, subscribe, share. Lock it in by hitting the bell. That is the goodness. Hit them with it and let's get to it. Okay, yo, I'm very familiar with this one. I'm pretty sure everybody who's watched. Oh, they got lyrics too. Okay. Okay, I see. At first, I thought that the lyrics were for Ruby, but it's for the whole crew. It seemed like. I ain't gonna lie, they knocked it out of the park with this being their first intro too. This is what we ain't heard yet. Right? Does this have something to do with the actual plot of the show? The lyrics? Because it looks like things are going to, you know, hit the fan, if you know what I mean. I'm just kind of, you know, kind of putting the pieces together in my head. Hey. Ooh. Now somebody going harder. I mean, you know, the drums is holding it down, but that guitar is turning up. There's more? Oh, no. They're breaking it down right quick. Nah, that was nasty. Hold on. Wait, I want to hear that one. Ooh, okay, nah. I'm glad y'all told me, because I would have never seen that, bro. Off rip. Okay, nah. They cooked with that. Hold on. I'm gonna just say a few things. They cooked with that, bro. They, like, you think, oh yeah, you know, the main song that we hear every episode of Volume 1 is good. It's like, okay, But then when they continue, it's like, wait. Y'all got to do season 10. They might have to pull a One Piece, right? Yeah, if y'all know, like, episode 1000, episode 1, they ran the first theme back. For, like, I don't know how many episodes they are on technically right now. But for, like, their 10th season or something, for, like, the beginning of it, yo, run the first song back. And let the whole thing play through as just, like, and make that episode, you know, add, like, I guess the song is, like, 3 minutes. Add 3 minutes into that episode. Let it be a normal full episode. Excuse me. But let that song fully play through as, like, its own special intro. That would be so fire, bro. All right. Now this gives me like just a quest vibes. Is this the red trailer? It was one of the trailers. I'm listening. Good little change up. Okay. Changed the whole like feeling around the song. All right, so look, I'm an avid gamer, right? So I don't know, I guess it's the guitar or that string instrument, but it's just giving me Assassin's Creed like 2 main theme vibes, right? And I loved Assassin's Creed 2, so I'm enjoying this. And then they change up again? With just the drums? Then bring it back in, keep the energy up. This has a grandiose and like fun energy around it, bro. I don't know how to put it into words correctly. I guess this is like Band of Sisters battle music for real. I can see all of them having a moment to the switch ups on this. And somebody getting dropped. Or a lot of Grimms. Wait, is this a whole different song? Hold on. Where are we? We at 6 minutes in. We 6 minutes in. I saw a comment. Okay. So we are, I believe, Mirror. I think that's where we at. No, that was still the second song. Yeah, this something soft, bro. I like, or at least the intro song. Okay, this is officially Mirror. I'm guessing from the white trailer. Okay, I like the little flip on the mirror from, I believe it was Snow White, right? Casey Lee Williams, that's who the singer is. She got a ethereal voice. I don't know what this is called on the piano, but I love hearing it every time. I'm sorry. This is nasty, bruh. I'm just getting the feeling of the fifth element, bruh. I'm gonna tell y'all everything that kind of triggers in my brain off of what I'm hearing. Hey, yo, y'all told me she was young when she did this, and I'm listening to it, and it's like, ain't no way she was under 18, honestly, and this is just because of how well, her voice is trained. I'm like, I was sitting there listening to the note, thinking back on the note she hit, and then she switch up here, and it's like, you were hitting them type of notes under 15? Jeez, not talent, bro. Just talent. If this is really from the Weiss trailer, right? And this is kind of a depiction of her character, I can see it. Because she's kind of an oddball out, right? Especially now with everything that happened by the end of Volume 1. Because, you know, Ruby and Yang, they sisters, they, you know, on a similar wavelength. And then, I mean, Jean and her, and they're like, Ruby kind of is friends with a lot of people, right? Yang, she already had her friends that she they kind of stated in the first episode. But then again, she said she has her sister, she does her own thing. Her personality is, it seems like it's easy for her to make friends. Blake ultimately got Song Wukong. It was at the end, but she got Song Wukong. Weiss, on the other hand, because she's very confrontational, and you know, she's been butting heads with so many people. And then I don't know how her family life is, because, you know, a lot of times when your parents own businesses and are moguls, they a little bit of neglect happens. So I could very well see that happening with her character at home, too, especially because she has that rich girl mentality where, you know, in a lot of stories and stuff, you see parents, they try to cope with being bad parents by buying their kids whatever they want, which ultimately, deep down inside, they just might want some time spent. So look, for everybody who is, you know, planning on having kids one day, spend time with your kids. I gotta remember that too. I ain't got kids, but when I do. Ooh, this. Something from anime feels like it was inspired from this. From that little opening. Nah, I like this one. Like, they all been good, but it's something about this, like, this dark, like, the dark undertone of this. Night City driving in a cyberpunk universe song. Off rip. And I don't mean the game, I mean any cyberpunk.
Intruder, identify yourself.
That's from the robot, right? And they threw it in the actual song? And then she got on the beat correct too. For the instrumental. Yeah. Okay, so I said cyberpunk, right? And I'm still standing on that. What genre of world do they actually live in? Cause like it's medieval guns. So it's like, and it's not like, it feels somewhat steam, a slight steampunk, like sprinkle on it. It almost feels a little less steampunk than Legend of Korra, if that makes sense. But the guns are more advanced, more like cyberpunk-esque guns. I just thought about this. Ruby has like a weird world that is set in, cause then there's magic and dust and all of that. Just interesting to think about. This song is called From Shadow. Okay. This isn't the I had to look, tap back into the lyrics. Very fitting to the, I think it was the White Claw and the Faunus people. I like this sound, bruh. Jeff Williams? Are they? All right. Are they? Because if she's 13, it's either her brother or her dad, right? And if it's her dad, I see where she get it from. That's what I will say. I see where she get it from. Because he's actually good. He sounds good too. So it's like, yeah, I don't know. It's almost like Billy Ray Cyrus and Hannah Montana. I feel like that's a bad, like, you know, comparison because of everything that, you know, go on with them and in the, you know, celebrity world. But when it comes to actual talent and like you kind of passing it down, I think that's pretty good. Who is the band behind this, though? Or is it, like, I wouldn't be surprised if it was them who played the instrument, too, because I haven't seen people do that. He going stupid right now. Like, I love when people get on a guitar and just have a good time and still match the vibe of the song, but they just go off, bruh. But I feel like letting people, or people who enjoy what they do to that degree, and it's a lot of, you know, guitarists out there that do it, but when they enjoy what they do, bruh, it makes music, I feel like it makes making music easy. He come back with the piano. Okay, that might be my favorite one so far. My favorite characters. Has someone else used this, like, melody before? Because I know this, like, I watched the trailer, yeah. But I know this melody way too, like, it's too familiar for just Ruby. Has anyone used this before? It might have been just a slight little bit, but it's, ooh, this one just is, like, flaring up in the head, bro. Again, Night City driving, bruh. I be speeding, I ain't gonna lie. I'm really just vibing with it right now, bruh. I caught it. Caught it. Hold on. I'm sorry. Okay, I didn't miss it. Where's Red? Hold up. Oh, did it was Red earlier on, and I didn't know that that's where we were going. Okay, this is like a remix of Mirror Mirror. Like the club mix of Mirror Mirror, bruh. I mean, compared to where the scene took place, it's fitting. Okay, so the first bar was Mirror Mirror from Weiss. This is Blake's. I don't know what genre of music it is, but it's always been nice. Like, the energy is that club scene. Okay, this is definitely Yang's music. Now, Yang music definitely gets you active, bro. You can box to it. Hold up. I gotta investigate what the songs were. So I Burn trailer version. Where we at now? Okay, we at, this is Gold. Okay. Is this also a Yang song? Cause I associate Gold with her. Definitely keeping that like tempo from I Burn though. I don't understand it, bro. Like, they really cooked so heavy with the soundtrack too. Like, you know, the animation, the story, and the volume one, y'all told me that, you know, volume one is like is the start, but it gets better. But it was already good. For a YouTube team to come together to make this is crazy, but then to give it some top tier music, and Casey Lee Williams is on the beat on just about every song, and she's sliding. How, bro? Like, and again, you're young. You don't have a lot of experience, but yet you got the natural talent, bro. Jeez. I just peeped. We halfway through. It felt like we just started. Hold on. I'm proud that I wore gold today, bruh. I just put it on and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna record this. Now I'm feeling real golden right now with the music. Some feel good music, I'll tell you that right now. Oh. Like, also, who is the band, bruh? Who are y'all? I need to know who they are, because they on them instruments killing it, bruh. And whoever composed it, too. Like, whoever put it all together. She hit them notes. If y'all seen the SpongeBob meme, right? When she hit them notes, it'd be like that. Like, just and then your soul just come out, come back in after the note. Ooh. She hitting them notes, bro. Like I said, she got an ethereal type of voice. Oh, this is the full thing. Yeah, I ain't lying. Yang went on a crazy run of music so far. Whoever on the guitar, you tough for that. Did I miss that the last time? If I missed that the last time, I'm bugging. Yo, in this song, Gang is talking her shit. That's all I can say. I will scrape you off the floor? Nah. You might as well be Karapika with the shovel.
The booth, human torch can't fuck with me. Johnny Blaze, suspect B, strike quick, lightning fast, melt them bitches down to ash. Gasoline.
Well, damn, hold up. I'm getting chill bumps right now. Hold up, I didn't expect that. And he got on the beat, started rapping, and he started talking shit too. Yo, look, I know what I said earlier, but yeah, Yang, you, like, it's not just the rap, it's the fact that they just talking, they are trash talking whoever they going up against, bro. And then she said, we can kiss and make up. Like, look, and I feel like it's on some, You can tell me you sorry and I'll forgive you, but only because you said you sorry. If you didn't say you sorry, I was just going to put you in the dirt energy, bro. Listen to it. Light your life away.
My desire, thought that you could see the truth till I just burned down the booth. Human torch can't fuck with me. Johnny Blaze, suspect B, strike him quick, lightning fast, melt them bitches down to ash. Gasoline, kerosene, strike a match, ignite the scene. Shit will never be the same. Feel the fury of my flame, beg for mercy, it won't help. Embrace the ending you were dealt. Seems you fucks will never learn. Now sit back and watch me burn.
Hey yo. Look, y'all should have, I'm just saying, Fire Force, call them. For y'all, whatever y'all new season, call them. Tell them, can y'all bring us this energy one more time? Our show is themed around fire. Can y'all cook something up, ignite it right quick? Cause he dropped hella flame bars. He said, Human Torch and Johnny Blaze. If I'm not mistaken, that's Human Torch and Ghost Rider, Hellfire, and someone who can get to the heat of the... Okay, just fire bars on a fire song. Just straight gas. Okay. Nah, Yang, you got it. And then you, as soon as he does, you come in with the guitar. Look, I'm getting very similar Linkin Park vibes, right? Especially with adding rap to the rock. And look, Linkin Park is all-time favorite band, bro. All-time favorite. Rest in peace, Chester, bro. To this day and forever, bro. And so for y'all to, like, incorporate rap, because I'm a rap fan. I mess with rock music less than rap, but by a decent bit. I'd say probably 4-1. I'm going to be real. I listen to anime music, too. So maybe that'll push it up to, like, I guess... 4-2. But nah, y'all, I don't know what got into y'all on this song. New number one. And it's so fitting because I told y'all, anybody who's ever asked, Yang is number one. And so I Burn, which is pretty much Yang's song. And look, he even got her with got the hands, the left and the right ready, bro. Okay. Y'all disintegrated whatever it was in y'all area. I may fall. You had me in the first half so far. I was like, dang, this is a Beldum song, a Melancholy song, a down song. Oh, hold up. He said, not by your hands. Yeah. I'm sorry. Anytime someone say wolves.
There's a place where our shields will shatter, and the fears all that's left in our hearts. Strength and a God for the
I had to relate this to anything from season one, I would relate it to, I guess, when Ruby was very unsure of herself. And you throw John's whole, like, you know, cheating thing, then pretty much being bullied, and then that whole little, like, saga from him. I think that this song could, for the most part, go well with both of them. It's just a down point of the character, of a character. But the way it's set up, they might, I may fall, but it doesn't feel like they gonna stay down type of music. Felt that one, bro. You cut everything out, let them sing, and then bring it back. I felt that one. Song of perseverance, bro. This is low key a cure for depression type of song, bro. Like, if something bad happened, you fall into a depressed state, you need like maybe five or six other songs and this one together, get you back on your feet.
Take it, couldn't stand another minute. Couldn't bear another day without you in it.
Okay.
All of the joy that I had known for all my life was stripped away from me the minute that you died. To have you in my life was all I ever wanted. But now without you, I'm a soul forever haunted. Can't help but feel that I had taken you for granted. No way in hell that I can ever comprehend this. I wasn't dreaming when they told me you were gone. I was wide awake and feeling as I had to be wrong. How could you leave me when you swore that you would stay? Now I'm satisfied with every single effing day. It's like a movie, but there's not a happy ending. Every scene's made black and there's no pretending. This little fairy tale doesn't seem to end well. Cause the lightning's shining, I'm ruined away from the spell. I know it's
so, guessing this is a little telling on her mother and her relationship to some extent. Part two, okay. I'm making the face because I'm just thinking of whoever put the original intro together, right? The OG, I think Red Like Roses Part One, I believe that. Let me go back to it. This will be the day is the original. I'm just like thinking this song, I guess Red Like Roses is was Ruby's song, her trailer song. This could have been used as well. Like, it could have been used for the intro or for Ruby's trailer, which, I mean, it is the part two. And, like, those two are respect, like, with all due respect, are not bad, right? But I'm saying that, like, a mid-season change-up with this being the song for a new animation or, like, a new intro? would have been fire. I don't remember where this song, or if this song actually came into the actual like story at any point. I don't remember it, but it is a good song. I like this cadence that they own and style. And you. I'll wait. I'm reading the lyrics and listening. Petals scattered now. I'm trying not to lock completely into listening mode and just be sitting here with my eyes closed. I forget that I'm actually making a video here. I like to pause and jump back in every time. It almost got me that time, but I knew it. Hold on. I'm just mind blown, bro. That is it, bro. This is a truly mind blowing experience of y'all gave such good quality, and y'all, it's like less is more too. Like, yeah, y'all, not when it comes to the number of songs, but when it comes to y'all didn't go get like some huge major singer. And like a huge, I don't know about the band. I don't know who the band is. I can't say this, but I feel like it was, y'all made a masterpiece with crayons for the most part, if that makes sense. Like y'all, Rooster Teeth, especially 10 years ago, did not have a lot of money and resources to do some extravagant things that, you know, but y'all, which with you they had, they've made anime quality music and a show that is, from what I've been told, gets better and better. And it is of anime. Isn't it on Crunchyroll now? Y'all went from just a YouTube channel to Crunchyroll, which is the only other person that I actually, you know, consistently know of that done that is Vivzy Pop recently. So it's just impressive. Okay, y'all went a different route because I was about to say, I am Iron Man.
It's not a long.
Is this outro?
Time.
Or was this Blake's sadness?
Patience. seem to fill your life.
I guess maybe not sadness, but like this whole moment between her and Weiss and the fondness.
Disappointed. Don't let your heart break. Don't spend another minute in this way. It's okay.
Yeah, it's from that episode. That's the end. Hold on, I'ma just make sure that I don't, you know, miss nothing. I'ma marvel. Okay, that's the end. Yo. Ooh, that's number two. I Burn, full version is number one. That's number two. What is the name of that one? Wings? Yeah, nah, that one. And I'ma tell you what really got me on that song. I was like, I didn't want to say anything because I'm listening and like, I'm listening to her sing, but I'm also listening to the string instruments. I think it was a violin, but in the background, bro. And it's like, nah, it's a relaxing song. You see, I'm sat back in the chair. You know, normally I'm up like this, you know, nah, it's like, after listening to that, bro, I don't even need to sit up, bro. I am chilling now. That is, okay, Rooster Teeth. Congratulations. Y'all have blown my mind. I've talked about it multiple times already. Y'all made a fire OST. You know what? I don't have a lot of OSTs, so I think by default it goes into my top 10. Like, if y'all want to know my number one OST ever, is Air Gear. What is it? What a Groovy Trick. That is, I think, and the band is Skank Funk. It's a weird, yeah. Hey, I'm just saying, if y'all have never heard that, I suggest you listen to that one time. But nah, this definitely, like, this is one of them OSTs that I'm gonna remember. I will say. And then it's like 8 other seasons. And if they keep getting good, better, if they get better for one, Jesus. So this, my OST list might be flipped on its head. I'm gonna say that now, by the time I get done with this series. But yo, I appreciate everybody that told me to listen to, because this is not just a watch or just a listen. This is low-key an experience. And it especially, I hate when y'all write, but I love when y'all write at the same time, because it's an experience, especially after watching season one and you listen to the OST and you remember all the scenes that things relate to. Like, I'm over it. Like, I immediately caught the stray episode at Wings. But then I'm going to just go back. Red Like Roses Part 2 still gets me. I May Fall. I felt like that was when Ruby was very unsure of herself as team leader and stuff. And you could honestly throw the John thing in with that as well. I Burn is Yang's whole persona. But then, you know, the other ones like Mirror Mirror from Shadows and I Burn trailer version are the trailer. Gold, I feel like Gold was just the energy that Yang and Ruby as sisters would give each other. You know what I mean? And then This Will Be the Day is the true song of the show. And like I said, bro, This Will Be the Day, Red Like Roses, and Red Like Roses Part 2, you could have thrown any of the three. This Will Be the Day is the actual intro. But you could have thrown any of those three as the intro, and it would have been fire. And I feel like we're going to keep scrolling. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 that can be, out of 10 songs, three of which can be the intro is a fire, like, percentage. Because I feel like a lot of OSTs probably don't have that kind of, you know, conversion number. Like, I'm one of my other favorite kind of OSTs is Mass Effect. I don't think that even my favorite Air Gear, their main theme is Chain. And I don't think that there was a replacement song that could have been the main theme for Chain, right? Or like something as iconic as Shiki no Uta from I can't think of the anime right now. But if you know, I can't think of the anime right now. But a lot of those songs are iconic to the point where it's nothing that can replace them. I would say that those three can replace each other. That's like the consistency of good. Like, no song is below good on this list, right? And those three are great. My personal, my personal amazing S tier, oh my God, I might have to download this song, is Burn, because of Yang and because of, they were talking that shit. I don't care. They were talking that talk on that song. And then Wings is just a relaxing song to listen to. And so, yeah, nah, y'all, this is a 10 out of 10 OST, bro. Like, y'all knocked it out the park. Rooster Teeth, if y'all see this video, y'all killed this. That is it, bro. That's all I got to say. Shout out to everybody who left a comment telling me or asking me, am I going to react to this? Because I was going to do it after, like, one or two people said it. But then, you know, people doubling down is like, I really have to do this, bro. I don't know what this OST is about to give. Because, I hear the songs, some of the songs that come out in the episodes. But it's like, they really put a lot behind this, bro. And with 8 seasons now and some spinoff series and all that, I feel like they got their due diligence. They got their flowers from the fan base. With that being said, bro, if y'all enjoy this, go to Rooster Teeth. Like I told y'all before, hit them with the goodness. That's like, comment, subscribe, share. Lock it in by hitting the bell. That is the goodness. Hit them with it. Go to their website. You know, go ahead and log in, watch some stuff. Go enjoy. If y'all haven't caught up with Ruby, go catch up with Ruby. I ain't caught up yet, but you know, that's because I just started. I'll be caught up. If y'all lacking, I might lap y'all. I'm just saying, yeah. But yeah, go support them, bro, because they are. Think about a small team making this and think about what they've grown into. It's a passion project. You always got to support passion projects, especially when they're good. But with that being said, this has been your boy, Reggie Wolf. I am signing out. Peace.